Snoop Dogg over here, wee.
So at the start of 2019, Liam and Rocco bought themselves Boomtown tickets, and for months I did not hear the end of it. Little did they know that they had actually persuaded me and I'd got myself a ticket, but the catch was I was not going to tell them. Just dropped them off, now it's time to get ready. Alright, well, we all packed up. The boys have no idea that I'm on my way. Let's get this Boomtown going. I made it into the festival after a pretty heavy security search, and I found the boys chilling at the campsite. Little did they know that I was about to sneak up on them and surprise them.
Yeah, boy!
Yes! Yes!
You
f***ed up!
You!
Idiots.
He's known for a month.
Of course he has.
It was definitely a roller coaster of emotions. Rocco could not believe that I'd lied to his face like that. Bless him. And I do apologise, Rocco, but you must know that is not the last time that you're going to be surprised. The surprise was done, and it was time to kickstart the first day.
Oh, yes! Oh, yes!
After the first day, we went and caught up with our cousin Katie, who had seen the previous night. Let's just say things didn't quite go to plan.
Of course, Ryan, on his bad luck streak, had to go and take it one step further. We're sat in the circle, Ryan's talking, and before we could do anything, a wasp was flown into his mouth.
This is literally the worst thing that could have
happened. How gutted are you?
Like, why is it me all the time?
So today, I'm gonna find out what it's like to be judged in public for a wasp sting on my lip. Look at it! No! You're kidding! Oh my... You're kidding me!
I got stung by a f***ing wasp.
Yeah, okay.
I was looking at me so weird!
I honestly have not laughed this hard, probably ever. It was so funny, his lip had swollen up. At first he didn't even think the wasp had stung him. A short 5 or 10 minutes later, it became very apparent that he got stung.
On the journey back to the campsite, I decided that I was going to do a little test on my friends to see how noticeable it was.
How many people am I going to have to tell?
Don't say anything, don't say anything.
Don't tell them, don't tell them. As if they wouldn't notice. You got the fattest lip I've ever seen.
Yo.
Hello.
Hello.
No!
Got stung by a f***ing wasp on my
way. Oh my god!
I was seeing how long it would take you guys to notice.
You are f***ing kidding me. Holy sh!
I've
you look
mare.
Terrible, mate.
I've had an absolute mare.
And as I like, as I breathed in, it like
you
sucked
just
into
cut it off.
Holy
it looks like we could literally.
It's like a grape in my mouth, boys.
Obviously, the wasp thing was not an ideal situation, but I feel like I managed to somehow improvise an outfit together with my bandana, thus covering my horrendous deformed lip.
Despite the bee sting, somehow, I managed to get a little bit of fashion sense and kind of turn it around. Lip is looking, not amazing, but let's roll with it.
This got Rocco thinking. Rocco decided that he was going to try and come up with a funky outfit for the day as well.
I think it was actually as well when you turned up in the all green leafy Mystic shirt and shorts combo. Rocco, being the man he is, decided he would step up to the plate and decided to cut nipple holes in his shirt.
He didn't cut them in. One morning we were in his tent and he pinches his shirt and goes, "Here, Raz, burn some nipple holes in there." And then he took it one step further and go with the nipple chain.
Put it on.
Ryan.
What are you doing, Rocco?
Quick.
Wait, let's put your hands down so we can see it.
Which we didn't like, so we had to rip that off it.
It's a nipple chain.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Oh, I think another highlight was one day we were sat chilling just by our little campsite. We look to our right, we see a load of people there dancing around what looked like someone to be asleep in a chair. To cut a long story short, the kid was asleep in the chair. Everyone was raving around him at the same time trying to be quiet so he didn't wake up. And then they carried him at least 200 or 300 meters up the road. So obviously the kid eventually did wake up, thank God. And when he came around, the hype was unreal. He was so confused, it was
imagine
unreal.
Falling asleep and then just waking up. I mean, I know Rocco gets pretty scared when he wakes up, but this guy was something else.
So amidst all this chaos, we still found some time to go for a little boogie with our mates, and it was pretty insane, to say the least.
Shut up. Survivor wanna run, go speak up. Load up the skelly, they got them brain fi leak up. Swell up the whole chest on your inner D cup. And if you try run, me splash your knee cup. We no trace like y'all feelings, don't keep up. 40 in a the clip, chase now store up. And if you bizarre, no not at all. Your family be a go left them all. Yo, sit up, shut up. Me right.